turning a blind eye to where the money was coming from, even if it was from child traffickers, sex offenders, or high-risk sanctioned countries. Australian regulators accused the nation's second-largest bank, Westpac, of a whopping 23 million breaches of money laundering laws.
And Westpac failed to carry out appropriate customer due diligence on high-risk transactions to the Philippines and Southeast Asia concerning known financial indicators relating to potential child exploitation risks.
Westpac responded saying they self-reported cases to regulators and they said such breaches should never have happened. Australian regulators are pursuing fines of up to 21 million Australian dollars for each breach. In theory, that amounts to a whopping 483 trillion Australian dollars, or nearly 300 trillion euros in penalties. Westpac will not have to pay that hefty a fine, which amounts to over three times the global economy. But the accusations are throwing the Australian banking sector back into the spotlight. Australia's four biggest banks were accused earlier this year of rampant malpractice. And last year, the largest lender, the Commonwealth Bank, paid a settlement fine of 700 million Australian dollars for 53,000 similar breaches. With 19.5 million international fund transfers that went unreported, Westpac has entered into an entirely other level of misconduct, one that regulators say has propped up child trafficking, drugs, weapons, and dirty money from across the globe.